Hello everyone, how are you dear students? I hope you all are fine and doing well at home. It's time for maths lecture. So students, let us begin. In our last lecture, we started exercise 4.3. So today, we are going to continue it and we will finish the exercise. So we are done with the six questions A, B, C, D, E, and F. So today we are going to start with part G. So part G is 42 into 2. Part G is 42 into 2. So, as we always start from rightmost position, ones position. So, again, we'll start from ones position. So, 2 into 2. 2 twos are 4. 2 twos are 4. As we multiplied in ones, so we will write result below ones. Now, 2 into 4. 2 into 4. 2 fours are 2 fours are 8. So we will write 8. So 42 into 2 is equals to 84. If you want to solve this multiplication questions, then you need to learn tables. If you don't learn tables, then you need to add repeatedly, and that is lengthy process. So if you want to solve quickly, then you need to learn tables. Okay? So now, after G, the next part is part H. Question H is 86 into 3. 86 into 3. So, again, from where we will start? We will start from rightmost place, and the rightmost place is ones place. So 3 into 6. 3 sixes are 18. So for writing 18, we will write 8 below 1s and 1 below 10s. Why? Because look at number 18. Number 18 is having 8 ones. So we had written ones column the number 8 and 1 10. So we had written this one in the form of carry in tens column. Okay, now 3 into 8. 3 ones are, 3 twos are, 3 threes are, 3 fours are. Remember the table of 3. Recite the table of 3, and where you will stop? You will stop at 3 eights are. 3 8s are 24. 3 8s are 24. In this 1, we'll add this carry. We are having 1 as carry. So 3 8s are 24, and 24 plus this 1. So 24 plus 1 is 25. So now we will write 25. Now we are writing 5 here and 2 in the form of carry. See, no number is there, so we will write 2 as it is. So 86 into 3 is equals to 258. So note down both the question and solution properly in your classwork copy. Writing beautiful handwriting. We remember while noting down, write ones below ones, tens below tens, and if hundreds, then hundreds below hundreds. And we remember about mentioning the date. All noted down properly. So now moving further. Okay, so the next one is question I. Question I is 27 into 8. Multiply with ones first, then afterns will multiply with tens place. 8 to 7. 8 into 7. 8 sevens are 56. So 456. Look at number 56. 56 is having 6 ones and 5 tens. So this 5 we will write in tens column in the fourth carry. See, if you want to solve the question quickly, you need to learn tables. So 8 sevens are 4. Think 8 sevens are. You need to recite table of 8. 8 ones are. 8 twos are. 8 threes are. 8 fours are. 8 fives. 8 sixes are. And 8 sevens. So where you will stop? You will stop at 8 sevens. So 8 sevens are. 56. Or 56 is having 6 ones and 5 tens. So we have then 6 below 1s and 5 below 10s. Eight into two. So eight twos are 16. Now what about this 5? We will add this 5. We will add this carry in number 16. So 16 plus 5 is, all of you add 6 and 5. 16 plus 5 is
21. Very good. Sweep and right, 21. And below 10 and below 100. So 27 into 8 is equals to 206. The next question. One.